might sound obvious. But for those of us who live inside our own heads, we often secretly hope to be seen without ever revealing ourselves. We desire to be heard, yet we forbid ourselves to speak. How can we expect others to know us when we present them with nothing to see, feel, or understand? How do we expect to be found if we're ghosts in the lives of others? We are unimaginable. We want to be found without even being there. We are invisible unless we choose visibility. When we hide from the world, we're also hiding from ourselves. A young outcast will often feel that there is something wrong with himself. But as he gets older, grows more confident in who he is, he will adapt. He will begin to feel that there is something wrong with everyone else. As an introvert, you crave intimate moments and deep connections, and those usually aren't found in a crowd. In an extroverted society, a world that seeks connection, we oddly avoid eye contact. We time our text responses in order to protect ourselves from seeming too eager or too interested. And we hold our feelings back because we don't want to seem overly emotional or unreasonable. We silence our instincts. At the end of the day, instead of feeling good about ourselves, we feel alone. We feel misunderstood. Remember, it is okay to be emotional, to seek help, to confidently tell someone you enjoy being around that you are infatuated with them. There is nothing wrong with vulnerability. With being human, for that is what creates depth within our relationships, and that is what ultimately unifies us. It is an absolute human certainty that no one can know his own beauty or perceive a sense of his own worth until it has been reflected back to him. In the mirror of another loving, caring human being, love is our true destiny. We do not find the meaning of life by ourselves alone. Find it with another. The difference between an introvert and an extrovert is that an introvert is often unconsciously deemed guilty until proven innocent.